it's time for humanity to stand up in the info war and say, I don't know what's going to happen at the end of this, but you want to fight? You better believe you've got one!
From the front lines of the information war, it's Alex Jones.
That released yesterday evening, but it's breaking in the news today. On Tuesday, March 7th, 2017, WikiLeaks unveils Vault 7, the largest ever publication of confidential CIA documents. Another Snowden emerges. Yes, let me be specific. This has been leaked by patriots inside the Central Intelligence Agency. So was all the information that you saw unfold during the campaign. None of it came from the Russians. The Russians hacked into the East Anglia facility that was running over 1,000 universities, false thermometer temperature readout data scam. The Russians admitted to that. That was 6 years ago. That affected the Russians, an attempt to make them have carbon taxes. And I salute them standing up against the fraud that is the carbon tax. And the Russians have done other successful hacks, but almost all of what you've seen has been leaked by U.S. intelligence. I was told this by people high up, still in the government, but also outside the government. You're never really out of it, that this was all coming 2 years ago. I told you it was coming. I've also said probably 100 times since the election, if the globalists don't back off and leave Trump alone and the American people, that new WikiLeaks are coming, even more damning, that will destroy Obama. Now, everybody's freaking out right now. It's that your TVs are watching you, your cell phones are watching you, how it wires into all these private corporations, how these private banks are able to manipulate the stock market and control it, how they're blackmailing the media, how they're blackmailing Congress. Why do you think Trump came out 3 days ago and said, you're wiretapping me? Well, they'd admitted they were doing it. Remember, oh, we have the communiques of Flynn and the Russians. But that was a bluff. There was nothing there. The head of the Intelligence Committee in the House, Nunes, says there's nothing there. And all these other top-level people are saying, watch out, Trump was being illegally spied on. And now, this massive treasure trove of tens of thousands of documents, a nightmare for the New World Order is here. And I've warned Hillary and I've warned all of them, and I don't say this from a position of a power trip, I'm just a messenger, but somebody who's willing to do it and go through the things that happen to a messenger who delivers this information. But I am very honored to be a major messenger. Trump's much bigger messenger now, and others are coming as well. Now, Snowden's a big messenger. But make no mistake, this is only the beginning. The pedophile rings, everybody are going to be exposed. That's why they're completely panicking. That's why they're completely going, you know, crazy right now. It's why their minions have been activated to yell and scream and all over the country. They tasered, they beat, they shot, they pepper sprayed men, women, and children viciously. They're calling for civil war. They're calling for death. They're calling for destruction. Then they had some Media Matters piece that I'm calling for Trump to be violent. I said if they try to organize violence in the streets, as Newsweek has done, a case for rioting, a case for civil unrest, and if they call for Trump's death, that's illegal. You're trying to organize violence. We don't want to be violent. We're going to destroy you with the information. And by the way, that means weaponized info, the truth. But yes, if you really want a physical fight, I would advise you to back off right now. I want stability. I want a good stock market. I want jobs. I want freedom. I want the $1,400,000,000+ in new infrastructure that's been announced by the government and private interest in just the last 3 months since president was president-elect. The return of a real president, 45. If he's successful, it will dwarf anything George Washington ever did, and we're all doing this together. Trump cheers Exxon's plan to create 45,000 new jobs in just the next 4 years, dealing with hundreds and hundreds of billions of dollars of investment in Texas and Louisiana alone. Yes, absolutely. It's happening now. What do you think getting Rex Tillerson in there was all about? Total delivery. That's just the latest in the last 5 minutes. This is the beginning of the end of David Rockefeller's New World Order. Stand by. We'll return. All right, I think it's time to go ahead and announce some things here on air so that the globalists and their minions understand exactly what they're facing. Their higher-ups have known this for a long time, but their minions don't know. Globalist forces, dysfunctional saboteur types that want to bring this country down, that want to enslave humanity and be social engineers. You have been undermined for decades, and the patriots inside our government and others have been quietly preparing for your absolute and complete defeat. Not your overthrow, but your legitimate defeat. Because you can't overthrow something that's illegitimate. You're just being removed. A lot of people are freaking out right now because they know this is the broadcast that told you they have kill switches and remote control in all the airplanes for at least 25 years. All the modern airplanes. We're the ones that told you they can remote control your car right off a bridge and gave you the documents. We're the one that told you over 20 years ago that television sets were watching and listening to you. We told you they could switch on the microphone in your regular landline, not just your smartphone. We told you everything. And because patriots inside the different agencies were unable to speak out, my show was early adopted, not officially, as a place to dump information. And so I had NSA whistleblowers, corporate engineer whistleblowers, you name it. I mean, you've seen for many years the Thomas Drakes, the William Bennies, the technical head of the NSA come on the show, the former NSA folks from 20 years ago blowing the whistle as well, like Wayne Madsen. I mean, there's countless great people out there. So it's not about us getting credit. It's about people understanding we've been absolutely on target. And that's why I was told many years ago that in large divisional groups in the Defense Department, in Defense Intelligence, in the CIA, in the NSA, in the Geospatial Group, in all of them, they would call people in entire meeting rooms and say, this guy's young, he's wild, but he's done the research and has the sources. He's dead on. This is the voice of America right here. Alex Jones. We don't know how he came up with InfoWar, the way to counter it, why we don't have that website, we don't know. This guy's doing it all. He's reverse engineered it. This is the guy to listen to. And I obviously didn't want to tell you that, even though I knew that 15 years ago. And this morning, some folks I know got calls, and they were like, yeah, we got ordered 12 years ago to listen to Alex Jones. SEAL Team 6, you name it. That's because we did it. We resisted. We stood up. InfoWars is on target. And if people want to know some of the conversations I've had with Trump, it's been about that. It's amazing. I can't believe the intelligence community loves you so much. You've been dead on for 20 years? Wow. Yeah, I'm just now learning about all this. I mean, people want to know. Trump's learning about all this right now. About how they can remote control planes, how they can crash cars, how they can turn on microphones and cameras, all of it. And people were asking, how did I know this 18, 19 years ago? It was because there were a lot of engineers in Austin that were very wealthy that had been part of this that saw me on air talking about it and gave me even more intel. And Bill Clinton ordered people to surveil me. He ordered from our intel people to beat me up, to break into my house, to do a lot of really nasty stuff, try to set us up. And then all of a sudden, the decision was made before Bill Clinton even left. The military said, we're not doing this to Alex Jones. So they persecuted me up front and then decided this is a patriot. What the hell are we doing? Because they were surveilling me and turned me loose. So I've been in the jaws of this system by the grace of God. And it's just the right place, the right time, family background, being from Texas, people knowing I'm for real, that we've been leaders for at least 15, 16 years, hardcore, inside the government, because other people couldn't talk about this stuff. And they would say, you listen to Alex Jones, or you're ordered to listen to this. They'd be, what, the conspiracy guy? And they're like, it's not a conspiracy. He's dead on. This is the intel on the whole program. Listen to Jones. He's got it all. Because I've done the research. I've read the globalist books. I'm not that special, folks. You go read Carol Quigley's books, and you go read Bertrand Russell's books, and you go read Zygmunt Brzezinski's books, and you read Galton's books. Some of the stuff's 170 years old. Most of it's 60, 70 years old, 30, 40 years old. It's all there. I just read all the books. People act like they're professors. They act like they're intel analysts. They act like they're researching. They're not. They're just trying to act cool. I did it, and I'm not bragging. So I told you, big leaks are coming. Giant leaks are coming. And I said, Trump doesn't want to have to release all this because it can really hurt the country and hurt our intelligence gathering capabilities overseas. But it's all being done illegally by rogue groups to enslave the country, to blackmail, to have servers acting like they're in Russia, attacking things, which the intel community knows. Because they've got systems above that watch it. And they know they've been trying to set Trump up with Russians. And that's all come out in the news. It's up on InfoWars.com right now, Dr. Corsi. Vault 7, CIA can stage fake Russian hacking to undermine Trump. CIA kept Russian cyber attack techniques handy for false flags, and they did it to Trump. But the intel community then looked in Congress at the claims, and they were fake. And so they kept saying Trump's got a secret server. Yeah, they were running one right out of a van outside the Trump Tower trying to spoof his IPs, and they rolled the whole thing up, folks. That's why Trump is so pissed right now. He didn't even realize how bad it was. So I told you, CIA stole Russian malware, use it to misdirect attribution of cyber attacks. So it's all going to come out, ladies and gentlemen. Everything we told you is in the new docs, tens of thousands of them. How they break in your phones, how they compromise Congress, how they run sex operatives against Congress. And we always keep saying, why does the CIA do this? Why does the NSA do this? Because the American people have been in the dark because of the media. The media is the enemy. They're owned by the foreign assets. They're the problem. It's not the FBI. It's not the CIA. You think the CIA, mainly made up out of soldiers that went and dedicated their lives to this country, really want to bankrupt the nation and really want to end the family and really want to put cancer viruses in vaccines? They all know it's true now, and they're pissed. So I always knew in my heart, if we reverse engineered this thing, exposed it, that strong men and women in government and in corporations would come together and that we would beat the New World Order. I want to declare to the globalists, there's nothing you can do now. You can kill Trump. You can kill me. You can kill Ron Paul. You can kill Rand Paul. You can do whatever you want. You can shut the internet off. Nothing will stop this now. You are completely surrounded. That's why Brennan said you better watch your mouth to the president. It's all bravado. It's all arrogant crap. So I'll say it for the thousandth time. I don't work for any intelligence agency. I don't sit there and you know, have meetings with these people. I went out separately and did what only an independent journalist and freedom fighter could do with you, the listeners. So the credit for what's happening goes to the listeners. It goes to the whistleblowers. It goes to the supporters of this broadcast first, because without you, there's nothing. It's not I'm just giving you credit up front because I want to patronize you. You are the resistance. You think we're playing games here? You think I risk my life to lose? We're going to win! And nothing's going to stop that unless we stand down. And we're not standing down in the battle for the Republic. I am so honored to be part of this. All of you should be honored. You should be thanking God on your knees right now that you're alive right now and to be part of the defense of this Republic and the return of justice into the world. Because if America falls, my God, their plans were horrible. And we'd almost fallen. They planned to finish the job with Hillary. They were so arrogant, they ran that corpse as if we would go along with that. Their arrogance has been our greatest asset. But only now do they understand exactly what they're facing and what they're dealing with. Only now. And I'm going to warn all of them. I'm going to warn the fake media. You think there's not WikiLeaks and documents on how you're getting your orders from the foundations? What websites are being paid? Who's getting money from who? You don't think it's not known? You don't think that the New York Times can be destroyed with one mouse being punched? You don't think the Washington Post can be destroyed just like that? And you're going to make us destroy you. I understand that. I don't take any pleasure in that because you're already such scum. Hurting the country to bring you down is very, but if it's got to be done, it's going to be done. You arrogant Obama. You had the whole country in your control and hated it and tried to run it in the ground. All of you. Chuck Schumer. All of you are grasping low, evil, anti-human piles of trash. So what are you going to do now? Everybody knows. What do you think Chris Carter, who admits he gets advised by the CIA for his TV show for 20 years, said, I'm basing the whole new show on Alex Jones, not just the character. Alex Jones is a patriot. Alex Jones is right. Alex Jones is the model of the future. He told Vanity Fair that. He told Hollywood Reporter. I'm not bragging about that. Who do you think told Chris Carter which way the world's going? 7 months ago when the show came out, a year plus when he started production. Why would he be allowed to put a show out where Alex Jones is the hero and then say Alex Jones isn't racist in the real world? Alex Jones cares about humanity. because the CIA is almost completely converted back to the Republic. In fact, most of them were never away from the Republic. They were controlled by scum, and they were waiting for the people to create alternative systems to open up a wedge against the globalist. And now it's happening. You think the CIA wants war for Russia with no reason? We should be allies with Russia and dominate the planet, defeat all the tyrants? It's a natural alliance. There's real thinkers now taking control of our government that actually want prosperity and justice and peace. What's got to be dealt with? The last communist strongholds, Cuba, Venezuela, China, and the Islamicists. You deal with them. The sky and the stars are the limit. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back on the other side. But this is the InfoWar. I'm Alex Jones from the Central Texas Command Center, broadcasting worldwide in defense of the Republic. Well, Paul Joseph Watson's article's up on InfoWars.com. It needs to go total viral. Judge that's over the wiretapping says investigation into Obama spying on Trump would reveal mass surveillance of all Americans. Deep state petrified of pervasive spying being exposed. It's funny. Trump just got in and said that he's been spied on, and Obama and everybody lied and said they hadn't, and then all the documents got released today. It's good to have somebody ready to punch you scum right in your filthy noses, isn't it? Been bullying this country long enough. Now you're going to get your guts kicked in, scum, metaphysically. I told you, you want to fight, you got one. That's not bravado like you filth sit there and spew all day. You want an actual war? You're about to get 100 times what you ever imagined. Oh, look at Media Matters. Alex Jones tells Trump to use violence against his opponents. No, that's not what I said. I said they're using violence against us. They beat people up all over the country this weekend at the Trump rallies, tasered people, pepper sprayed them, and the police did nothing in the towns the globalists control. And they're trying to kill the president. They're calling for his murder. Have the grand juries indict every piece of filth that's calling for the president's murder. It's called the law. You people don't get to go around using violence and organizing it without being met. See, you attack us, you get attacked back. See how that works? Understand how that works? Get that through your mind that you've taken our kindness, our restraint as weakness. You have no idea. So there it is, InfoWars.com. It's all right there. And the judges have all been involved, but it's federal judges coming out, not just Judge Napolitano pointing that out. It's the head of the Intelligence Committee. It's former Attorney General under George W. Bush saying, oh, absolutely, they're surveilling everything. But here's the thousands of pages of documents released last night on Alamo Day. Just crazy. I called for the military to stand up yesterday and tweet and Facebook out articles and photos of yourself saying you support the president. Vault 7, CIA can stage fake Russian hacking to undermine Trump. Intercepted Russian communications, part of inquiry into Trump's associates, New York Times. Remember, they said that over a month ago, but now they say they never spied on anybody. And it turns out they were spying on the attorney general, then a senator, when he met with the Russian ambassador that was totally normal. WikiLeaks unveils Vault 7, the largest ever publication of confidential CIA documents. Another Snowden emerges. It's not Snowden. Snowden was part of a larger operation. And we've told you there's more Snowdens. And William Binney and Thomas Drake have told you there's more Snowdens. And they're getting ready to release things even bigger. And they released all the stuff on the Democrats you saw, which is only the literal tip of the iceberg. Below that tip is 99% of the stuff, and it's everything. Oh, you want them to release how Obama had Michael Hastings blown up? They all witnessed his car out of control explode. The engine shot down the road hundreds of yards, but oh, nothing happened. Let me tell you, my car blows up in the middle of the street. It's a bomb. What did Hastings know? Hastings found out about all this and more. And he said, we're at war with the government, and most of the media is bought off. They're at war with the people, and I'm going to be exposing it all soon. It's unbelievable. And he had learned it all. But see, How was that wife of his, the head person, the only aide allowed into the meetings of the National Security Council? She was at the funeral. I talked to people that were there. She said, oh, yeah, they murdered him. But then she went on CNN a few months later and said, oh, nothing happened. It was all completely normal. Michael Hastings was a government agent. He was with an agency. And he decided that things were so horrible, he learned about it, he's going to go public. What could that be? What could be so horrible that people that are around death and killing all the time say it's too much? Well, it's called the abuse of children. And so you already see the procurers of children being arrested by the thousands all over the country, caught. They'll catch them with 30-plus kids in a dungeon, and it's in one news article in L.A. or one article in Pennsylvania, in Philadelphia. Normally, that'd be all over the news, wouldn't it? But see, oh, it gets the police do their job, it comes out, but then it gets shut down. So there's a civil war going on against the white hats and the black hats and the government. Let me give you the news. The white hats have the initiative, the numbers. The bad guys are on top, but Trump is in a civil war trying to clean them out right now. So we got the guy on top. We're all below. We're going to meet in the middle in a pincer attack, and we're unstoppable if we pray to God. We're building the new world order, one based on nation states and based on industry and ideas and based on innovation. We're building the new world order on the ashes of the parasitic corporate world government that wanted to create a monopoly over humanity and merge with machines, claiming we were obsolete. The humans against the psychopaths and their machines are now beginning to strike back. Roger Stone's coming up here in a few minutes with big news. I talked to him last week, and he said, watch, you're going to see massive stuff unraveling this Russia situation very, very quickly. And I had the same intel. And now Trump has struck back. The intelligence agencies have struck back. This huge data dump, Vault 7, the largest ever publication of confidential CIA documents, everything we told you is in there. Because everything we told you was either reverse engineered in government documents from whistleblowers, you name it. We studied the big picture, integrated the intel of what the globalists said they were building. Now, we have this short report that I'm going to our guest. It's about 3.5 minutes long. It's called Zombified. And it deals with real videos. No matter where we go around the country, the majority of the anti-Trump people are violent. They're hateful. They're screaming. They're yelling. And they are tasering people, attacking, you name it, this weekend. It's all over the news. Just tasering old ladies, you name it. They seem to attack the weakest people, too. It's like a total coward instinct. A predator instinct. The anti-sheepdog instinct. And I'm really concerned because with the Prozac, the drugs, the TVs, the lowered IQs, the mesmerized state, the weakest amongst us have been turned into literal zombies because they have low brain waves, they're in a near sleep state, and they all have their tongue hanging out. They go like Body Snatchers. It's like at the end of the Body Snatchers, she's running around Washington, you know, the remake of the 70s. She goes, oh, it's you. And he goes, I mean, that's what they've turned into. Thank God we're not these people. Here's Paul Watson's report. Then we're going to Roger Stone with what's the biggest news ever. Vault 7. Then this is only the beginning. Biggest yet. More is coming. Here it is.
And now for something completely different.
When there's no more room in hell, the dead will walk the earth.
You can see her. She's literally zombie white, pot bellied, and her tongue's hanging out.
What the hell are they?
I mean, you look at the whole crowd, they're like, even the black people look white. They're like zombies.
USA!
But wait, give her a chance. When she calms down, she might have an actual argument.
I've seen the raw footage. He goes on for 30 minutes. Just,
just more autistic screeching.
He is You
don't mean autistic folks. That's actually what this
is. No, I know
says.
What you're thinking. This is just one individual. This isn't an accurate portrayal of the reasoned, credible, legitimate anti-Trump protest movement.
United States of America.
No. It's just total, like, baby toddlers throwing fists. This is what they teach at the colleges. They then bring them in, they play the Play-Doh.
I'm literally
this is when Trump got elected.
Tell myself that I'm not kidding. You better
see the mainstream media is their
right
friend.
Now.
They watch it. This is who watches Colbert.
I'm gonna die. I need
There's nothing more uncool than Colbert. There's a person in D.C. I mean, this is what they do. These are the nicer ones that don't attack you. The yuppies go F you, get in your face, scream at your kids. I mean, they are just entitled, hate-filled scum. Yeah.
The dead will walk the earth.
Joking aside, this is the effect that the mainstream media is having on people. This is what happens when you tell people over and over again that Trump is going to bring about the apocalypse. This is what mass hysteria looks like. This is what happens when collective insanity is legitimized by
the
media.
How dare him raise $3 trillion
from
the stock market?
The state
it's him making the phone calls, folks. All the new jobs being announced.
This is Trump derangement syndrome. And it's sweeping America.
When there's no more room in hell, the dead will walk the earth.
Yeah, and this is better to watch, though it's actually worse to watch. Infowars.com/show. For any listeners who want to see the feed, regardless, spread that link, folks. We're in an InfoWar here. You want to take the country back? This is it. America wasn't going to be easy to take down by the globalists. That went up last night, only has 347,000 views. That sounds good. A lot of Paul's videos get 5, 10 million, 15 million, 20 million, 30 million views. So again, I think this video, zombified anti-Trump protester, goes nuts. But you understand, this is the attitude. It's total selfishness. I'm in charge. I'm your God. By the way, at the end of that video, there's an ad for Roger Stone's book, which they've been censoring all over, not letting on the New York Times best-selling list. It's The Making of the President 2016, available at InfoWarsStore.com. That also helps our broadcast. And by the way, I saw it last night and tweeted it. Roger Stone has had his Twitter account taken for 24 hours, and they say there's more work you may need to do to give us value and build us up. You know, you're the reason Twitter exists, but he's tweeting about what's happening. He's a major political player. He can't exist. Let's go to my Twitter and show a screenshot, because his Twitter's gone right now. Of what he was told on his Twitter dashboard, that you've done something bad. We're not going to tell you what. It's very Kafka-esque, beyond 1984. We're not going to tell you what's happened. And you're banned for 24 hours. And there, quote, may be more work you've got to do. That's on Real Alex Jones on Twitter, if you want to see that. That's why it's more important than ever. I was so focused yesterday with all that was about to come out. You notice I didn't even plug yesterday but one time. That's right. Let's do a screenshot of that. There's a screenshot I tweeted out. I know that. That's it. You have been determined that it has violated the Twitter rules, so you will need to wait some time before using Twitter again. Won't tell you what you did. You will be able to unlock your account in 11 hours, 57 minutes. That's about the time we got a screenshot. Notice you may need to complete some additional tasks to resume using Twitter. And they also don't let most of his tweets be seen by people on Twitter. It's all about being gamed. You say, well, why are we on Twitter and Facebook? Because that's where the zombies are, and we're desperately trying to reach in to find out who may still be partly awake. So follow him at Roger Stone Junior, follow him, follow us at Real Alex Jones. It's so important. And I've got a bunch of specials. We're having free shipping throughout to next Monday on all the products, the nutraceuticals, the books, the videos, the non-GMO heirloom seeds, the water filtration systems, all of it. Free shipping on thousands of items, 50% off Trump Pence 2020, brand new shirt, $9.95. So everybody gets it. It's the next viral shirt. It is going viral now. My top viral shirt in the last year is 100,000 shirts or close to it. Folks, if we have a million people listening an hour conservatively, just get the shirt or make your own. I don't care. They got online t-shirts places like $15. You can design it yourself. Take my design. In fact, let's put a graphic on the site for free. If folks want to just print off the graphic and have it put on a t-shirt, if for some reason they don't want to get it from us, just stand up for free speech against these bullies. Just be seen. We'll break their back. We're so close to victory. I mean, like 8 different companies I saw this morning, from Exxon to you name it, just announced they're relocating to the U.S., hundreds of billions of dollars in the next 5 years. the average job is $100,000 paying each person. I mean, this is incredible. We're open for business again, but we've got to stand up for somebody risking his life, his treasure, everything. Donald J. Trump going upstream against the enemy and winning. Unbelievable. Thank God for this. It's happening. The catalyst is here. The victory's ours. Infowarsstore.com or 888-253-3139. You can't get a nice navy blue shirt, red, white, and blue, Trump Pence 2020. We're launching this whole movement, keeping America great. On the back it says, America first in 1776, Infowars.com. You want to meet like-minded people, defend the First Amendment, stand up to the bullying, which is only at these rallies. It's safe everywhere else. Then get the shirt, Infowarsstore.com or 888-253-3139. And maybe you already know all about the campaign and what happened because you listened or you were involved. Get the book. Give it to a so-called libtard and say, listen, actually see what's in here. Why are you so upset? Why are you mind-gamed, Jedi mind-tricked into believing all this garbage? Infowarsstore.com, free shipping. It's going for 7 days, and it's done next Monday, or I guess next Tuesday. Infowarsstore.com or 888-253-3139. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't like to get on air and, you know, talk about the sources we have and things over the years. And I got to tell you, the first time somebody who says they're in the CIA gives you information, and then you later learn they're a real person, senior in it, and that they really gave you real information, you're like, what the hell happened there? Am I being set up? You're like shredding the info. This kind of stuff happened like 18 years ago. NSA, you name it. But it's happened so much now, and we built the info war to fight it. And I was never involved with intelligence agencies. I didn't realize that I had people that had been involved in them that didn't like what was happening, leading me, helping me, mentoring me. People like Vic Vreeland, who was in Air Force intelligence and saw a lot of action in Vietnam, said, you're going to be the info war. That's what you do. Let's get this site here. It's yours. He was the fire department chief here in Austin, deputy fire chief. Great guy. Won't come on the show. He lives out in Bastrop and says, hey, I'm really old now. Great job, Alex. I'm done fighting. But it was like I was given all the intel just constantly by patriots. Didn't like what was happening. So then all these other people were like, who is this guy? What government does he work for? So they investigated me, looked at it and said, no, this guy's a natural. And then we built the info war. We did all this, and we've kicked their ass. And so going back more than 15 years, all these major intelligence agencies, I'm going to skip the breaks. We have more time with Roger. We're told the Patriot Group said, listen, Alex Jones, that's the channel. So we became the real voice of America, despite all our problems, and I'm not perfect. And so now most of the intelligence agencies are aware. They're involved. They were already aware, but our show crystallized it all, organized people. And now the globalists are in trouble, and Trump comes out, I'm being spied on, knowing they'd lie. Then all the data comes out that he was spied on, that they were having servers ping him, trying to set him in stone up. It's all coming out, folks. This is the counterstrike by Trump and the Patriots. This is so legend. Roger, is this not incredible, my friend?
Alex, I think we are on the cusp of the greatest single political scandal in American history. I think it is a scandal that will hasten and accelerate the realignment going on in this country. The deep state has been hit with a double whammy. They have gotten caught spying on the nominee of one of the two major parties, and their rationale, their phony rationale for that spying, has now been disproved. We now know, indisputably, despite the claims of Barack Obama and the disinformation pumped out by James Clapper, that the Obama administration, on the basis of no evidence whatsoever and no probable cause, went to the FISA court, the secret, super secret FISA court, first in June, requesting that Donald Trump and his associates, including yours truly, be put under surveillance. And they were, we believe, denied. We now know that they went back in October with something more narrowly drawn as far as candidate Trump is concerned, and this secret warrant to spy on the Republican nominee for president was approved. It is unclear whether the monitoring of my own email, my own text messages, my own cell phone calls was approved in June or in October, but it was indeed approved. So this is the naked political manipulation of the system, of the government system. Richard Nixon went down for Watergate. He didn't know about Watergate in advance. He didn't approve it. It did not utilize government agents other than perhaps the CIA agents sent to
it. Roger, this is exactly, and you were involved in all this, is 50 times bigger. Here it is, Catherine Herdage, top-level state operatives leak Flynn phone call transcripts. We already know that, but when she goes on Fox News, she's heavily embedded with the CIA and defense intelligence, you name it. When that lady, like a spy chief, gets on there and says that, you know they're totally turning on him. And didn't Trump set him up, having him deny it for 3 days before all this comes out? Let's be clear. This didn't come from the Russians. This came from the Central Intelligence Agency. And I was told a week ago, get ready for the next hammer to drop next week. Relax, Alex. Trump's on it. And so they want a war with Trump, man. That is showing he knows what he's doing.
Yeah, no, it's quite extraordinary. Look at the President Obama's carefully parsed response. He didn't order the surveillance. He's going to try to lay this off on Loretta Lynch as if his attorney general ordering it is not him. The buck stops with him. Nixon bore responsibility for what happened on his watch, and he went down. This went down on Obama's watch. There is no doubt whatsoever that you would spy on one of the two major party candidates for president without solid evidence of a need to do so of a criminal nature without the president doing so. This was a puff of air. This was a Clinton campaign press release. There still are, according to the House Intelligence Committee, and I'm going to give you this tape shortly, no evidence whatsoever of a contact between the campaign associates of Donald Trump. Those would include your...
Sure, that's all old news. Roger, I don't know if you had chances last night when this came out. I've got as many people as I can on this. Vault 7 is the whole map how they could kill airplanes, how they could kill cars, how they were trying to set Trump up with false flags, with Russian servers, how they were planning all of this, how they were putting out disinfo, how they were bribing and blackmailing Congress. I mean, this makes the original WikiLeaks and the stuff that came out during the campaign look like child's play. This is a hydrogen bomb dropped on the criminal deep state by the patriots in the deep state. This is the biggest scandal ever. This is mega massive. I don't know what they can do. And you see even the Fox News analyst that had been kind of stabbing Trump in the back all suddenly turning against Obama and Holder and Lynch and Clapper and Brennan. I mean, this is amazing.
No, the dirty tricks and the tactics of the deep state have now been, you know, exposed for everybody to see. These criminals have to be dragged in front of a grand jury one by one. In all honesty, I don't think a congressional inquiry is the way to go.
We need indictments under national security for illegal spying and sabotage for private corporate interests against the United States of America. It's espionage. It's a new type, though. It's corporate espionage against the republic. That's what globalism is.
It is not wise to go to Congress for a totally politicized investigation in which nattering nabobs of negativism like Elijah Cummings blather on and on about the CIA and these allegations without a shred of...
Look, they've all called for the president to be overthrown. The media's called for him to be killed. I'm not the one calling for violence. They're the ones here. I think they're very close to really getting in some big trouble.
This is why I think A.G. Sessions should unrecuse himself. What happened last year is very clear. The president hits it out of the park with the State of the Union. He's got a head of wind for his agenda.
That's right. Trump was already planning all this, but he's not telling the subgroups. And that's why whoever... Do you have word on who told Sessions to recuse himself and why Trump blew up Thursday?
I have no information on this, but here's what I know. Here's the sequence. Trump knocks it out of the park. The deep state leaks the session stuff to try to take the wind out of the president's sails. Trump comes right back with the wiretapping at Trump Tower, upping the ante.
Knowing this was about to be released.
He's the master.
Keep going.
Yeah, so in my view here, Sessions should non-recuse himself, or better yet, let's appoint a hard-nosed lawman special prosecutor and give him a grand jury. Ash Carter, James Clapper, John Brennan, these men need to be in front of a grand jury. Let's find out what they knew and when they knew it. Let's find out who the leakers are. Let's drag the whole first and second level of the Obama State Department and
CIA. Sure, Roger, Roger.
It's in, get to the bottom of this.
It's in the CIA data dump that they were trying to set up Trump and his confidants with fake servers from Russia and fake cyber attacks. So we now know, we have the head of the Intelligence Committee in the House saying no evidence, no phone calls, no nothing. So they've been caught with a bluff of surveillance. They did the surveillance. Now they're trying to say they didn't do it, even though a month ago they bragged they do it. They are up the creek without a paddle.
Yeah, it's very interesting the way they have inadvertently blurted out their game. Hillary Clinton tweets just days before the election that computer scientists have located a server in connection with Russia at Trump Tower. Clearly, is that a confection, do you think? Computer scientists who work where? The Central Intelligence Agency? Busted. Busted. She knew the whole thing in advance. They were all in on it.
Well, here's their problem, and it's all here now. It's all here that they were running fake servers trying to spoof the IP addresses of Trump Tower. The intelligence community saw through it. These traitors they've put in the CIA, we probably outnumber them, you know, just in the liberty movement, but also in government, 5-1 is the number I'm getting from good sources. Don't they get they're sitting right next to people that know they're the enemy, Roger?
It is quite extraordinary, but as I told you earlier, Alex, today, the most amazing thing to me is the extent to which the president is hard-driving on policy, not deviating on any of the policies that he pledged, whether it's restoration of Glass-Steagall, breakup of Dodd-Frank, building the wall, cutting taxes.
Obamacare's about to get deep-sixed. Obamacare's in deep trouble. They banned the tranny bathroom crap. All of it's happening.
At the same time, however, he is filling a government with quislings. This is my deepest concern for him. Anthony Scaramucci, widely respected and even revered by conservatives, a man who did yeoman service to the Trump campaign by raising money and providing wise counsel, a man who is a personal friend of the president, essentially squeezed out of a White House.
Well, let me stop you. That's Trump's only problem.
By a Bush guy.
No, I understand that. We'll do a whole other show on the appointments, but it's true that he's still doing his agenda, but it's Priebus and others that admittedly are the ones telling people to resign, telling people to recuse themselves, and Trump's blowing up. He needs to get rid of those people. Roger, we'll talk to you again soon. Paul Watson's in the fourth hour today, but if you want to come on the Nightly News tonight to get 20-30 minutes without any breaks to really lay all this out, we'll do it and talk about the bad side of what's happening with Trump. He's doing great in his agenda. He's got great people in the intelligence agencies, but he's got a lot of politicos. I guess as a business guy, you bring in the folks that used to run stuff, you think they'll follow your orders. They don't. And so I think that's his one blind spot. But maybe he knows something I don't know. Thank you so much, Roger. We'll talk to you soon.
Let's definitely do the news tonight because there is so much breaking news between now and then. I will learn much that our
listeners. Let them know when you want to tape it or come on live. Thank you. All right, joining us in this segment of the next and a little bit more, we got a bunch of other guests joining us. We are learning so much. Now, Dr. Steve Pachinik, of course, was at the State Department as head of psychological operations and other agencies. And, of course, with involvement with Delta Force, the founding of that, he has a lot of great sources. He's been spot on. I certainly have all my sources separate from his. So I don't know his view yet on Vault 7. I just know it comes out of the CIA as to show what criminal elements the deep state are doing and as a direct counter to the criminal deep state trying to block this America agenda and our president and the fact they tried to set the president up as a Russian. That's all in here that they're the ones doing it, and literally in trucks outside trying to spoof Trump's IPs. And so Congress has seen through it. Fox News has seen through it. I think we're seeing a collapse of the old establishment, this criminal globalist system right now. I'm very euphoric, but we'll see if Pachinik concurs. Dr. Pachinik, thanks for joining us. StevePachinik.com, co-author with Tom Clancy, of course, as well. What do you make of all this?
Well, as I told you before, and for some time now, we have had a civilian military confrontation in the intelligence community. Much of what you're seeing now in Vault 7, which is a release of over 9,000 pieces of information, was forewarned several months ago to me. I knew this would be a continuation of.
Sir, you said more big leaks are coming if they don't back off.
Excuse me?
You said more big leaks are coming if they don't back up.
It's not just a leak. Let me put it this way, Alex. We have a far more serious issue. As I told you before, when we initiated a counter coup against Hillary, this is once again an attempt to get rid of all those people who are impairing and distracting from Trump's agenda, as Roger said. But it's far more serious. This time around, the reason why these leaks were given was to simply take down the CIA. The CIA, as I've said, for the 30 years since 9/11 and elsewhere has been out of control. It has been out of control.
And let me ask you this. Why are there so many people in the CIA that are for this?
For what? For Vault 7?
For all this coming out.
Well, because they're good people. The CIA is not monolithic. What happened under John Brennan, what happened under Obama, this is a strict indictment of Obama and what happened with the increased surveillance of the CIA during the past 8 years and the previous 8 years under Bush Jr. And what happened, the honorable people within the CIA realized that this was a mandate that had been exceeded. In other words, this is criminal action. For the CIA to go into cyber communications,
this is leftist globalists using the CIA and NSA power to subvert the republic.
Well, let me be a little bit more expansive than that. This is not just the leftists and the globalists. This involves John D. Rockefeller, who was head of the Senate Intelligence Committee. This involves Susan Collins. This involves Mark Rubio. This involves Diana Feinstein. This involves many people who are over the Senate Intelligence Committee who were aware of this for over 8 to 12 years and did nothing.
They allowed this criminal action.
There is no question this is a criminal action. The reason this was released by my people and others who are literally caring for the republic and use Alex Jones as a means to get to the people of the United States was the simple fact that we can no longer maintain covert aspects to the CIA and cyber communication. One of the most important things that was released several months ago, and nobody realized it, was Zero Day, which was a film on Netflix. And Michael Flynn and General Michael Hayden was in it, and a bunch of others.
Stay there. We're back in 70 seconds. We'll keep you into the next hour with the next guest as well. I'm Alex Jones. This is the InfoWar. History is happening before your eyes, and you're all part of it. Spread the word to people. Tune in right now. Infowars.com/show. The battle for the Republic is now.